Hello. Look, that's David late again. That was him 10 minutes late. I know my timekeeping's not the greatest, but like he was 10 minutes late, and then he make it worse when I went outside to try and see if he was parking up in that knob end. Was outside having a fag. Well, I don't know. I don't think he's doing any training either. He's not, because he comes out with every single excuse under the sun. Right. Okay. I'll sit and talk to him then. Right. Okay. Right. Bye.
I know. Listen, Chris. Man, mate. Yep, listen. Come on now, come on. Don't get shot with me. Don't get shot with me. So I need to remember my P's and Q's, because I said the word p**ch last week, right at the start, and Facebook wouldn't allow Chris to promote the video, the vlog, because it contained profanities. So, Facebook, you bunch of f**ing f**kers, here are some f**ing beeps for you. Hopefully that'll keep you happy, ya p**ks. So here's the deal. For the last week and a half, I have been injured. My shoulder's taped what I've done on my shoulder. I've no idea what I've done, but it is, my mobility is poor. My cousin at Ferri Fit, she's been working wonders, to be fair. She took the pain away and gave me some sort of mobility back.
Oh, that was a big...
But ultimately, I haven't trained any upper body exercises at all since the last boot camp. I need to actually say how amazing the work that Kirsten has done. Having worked in the fitness industry, I've worked with countless sports therapists, physiotherapists, so I've had deep tissue, I've had dry needling, and she is phenomenal. She is actually really, really good. So anyone who's got an injury, I would definitely say she's definitely worth a shout to go and see. Or even as a warm-up massage before a workout would probably help massively, particularly if you're prone to injury.
If you put your arm back like the way you would with that stretch.
That feels much better.
Is it?
That one's gone further down than that.
I've been eating really good. I think I've not had anything really bad. My only criticism, and it is a fear, because it can actually work against you, is I've not been eating enough. And again, I've just been playing victim and saying, oh, I don't have enough time, I don't have this, I don't have that. And then I'm looking around, everyone else is dealing with their own shit, so I need to learn to actually deal with things. Chris, or Ferri as I call him, Ferri and I have had a chat. He kind of read me the riot act about my smoking and my commitment to this transformation. And I can understand why he's reading that act, in terms of, particularly since I've committed to doing a vlog for him and I've not been doing, putting in the effort that I should be. And I have to be honest, so it's like I am one for playing the victim quite easy, so I'll use any excuse to feel sorry for myself. I'm not proud of that, but that's my nature. And this injury, yeah, so I've almost used it as an excuse not to do anything. And Chris sat down with me and he said, look, you're not the only person in the world that has issues. I'm meaning beyond the shoulder, in terms of like when your home life is maybe a wee bit when things are out of sort at home or work, or people have been landed news and they're still living and still dealing with things. Just a lot of things put things in perspective. Like, for example, we played a gig last night and horrifically a friend of the bride and groom died actually before the reception kicked off. And they're made the tough stuff to me, that how everyone around went, well, look, this is meant to be this couple's best day of their life, and it's probably turned into one of their worst. They decided to celebrate that person's life and carry on and commit to actually seeing their wedding through and then trying to save their moments, like their first dance, and it was like a great sense of mortality. Those people have got tough stuff, and it's quite grounding for me because I'm not that type of person. Sorry for having been so f***ing negative actually here. Stop feeling sorry for yourself. Put on your big boy pants and actually do this. Just commit to something and actually do it. Don't throw in the towel because you've got a speed bump. I really thought I was made of tougher stuff than that. I'm in all honesty feeling a bit down about everything at the moment. I'm a bit f***ing scunnered, to be fair. I'm so sorry this isn't the humorous vlog that I've tried to edit the last couple of weeks. As any artist or artiste would say, if you don't feel it, you don't feel it. And this week I'm definitely not feeling the humour, so I'm sorry. Next week I promise we'll be better.